This is Hamish from the Maui Celtic Radio Show, and I'm here with George Miller from the Irish Rovers. Happy Hello. New Year, George.
Happy New Year to yourself and all the listeners. How are you?
Good.
Good, good.
New album.
Yes.
I've been playing a couple of singles from the album.
Yes, thank you for that.
But the new album is called No End in Sight.
Yes.
And that has many meanings right now.
Well, especially the way the world is these days, it does have a lot of meanings. I actually wrote it
before
all of that started. I started the song in Maui, as a matter of fact, when I was over visiting you and Jennifer. That's when I first started writing the song. And it was really about, in my mind, it was about us, the Rovers. I mean, we were at that time approaching 50, 51 years old. And I thought, how much longer is there? I mean, how long do we want to go? How long will the fans let us go? Which is probably the most important question. And after that, I realized we did another tour and the fans were great and they loved us. And lots of people are saying, you hope you're not going to retire. Others were saying, I hope you're going to retire. But more people were saying, I hope you don't retire. And that's when the whole song came together. So it was really more about us. But now that the world is in this horrible situation, it certainly works for that as well.
Yeah.
No end in sight, because now we're into, what, the fourth one now? Is that what it says? Omicron,
yes.
Or whatever the hell you call this one? And it seems to be no end in sight for that as well. But it also can mean no end in sight for happiness and joviality, and that's what we sort of portray, or that's what we like to portray, that's what we like to do ourselves. In this time of our lives and of everybody in the world, you just have to sort of smile and just get on with your life and say, this is the way it's going to be for a while. So make the best you can and smile.
And on that note, no end in sight for the band. Let's stick with the band version of that. And that's certainly the case for you writing songs. You've got about two or three albums up your sleeve right now.
Well, I started, well, because of the COVID and being home a lot more than I normally would be, I started, I suppose most entertainers started writing more or rehearsing more and getting better at their craft. And so I wrote quite a few songs and we've recorded some of them. We're still able to record because we're not in a big studio with 50 or 60 people. We're in a small studio, just the two or three of us do it. And then I send it over to Ireland to the boys there and they do their parts in Morris's place, in his little studio. And from there, we just, it comes all together that way. So we're not all together at all the times. But it's amazing what you can do nowadays with recording, where you couldn't do things like this a few years ago. Now you can. You can send it by email. Like I'll put on a guitar part and send it over to Ireland saying, can you add a little bit of accordion to this track? And they put it on and overnight they send it back to me and voila, I have an accordion piece on there as well. So it's quite amazing what you can do. And yes, I do have a few songs in reserve and probably I have another full CD and two or three besides.